गुड आफ्टरनून स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम। आई एम जी डी पाटिल, के क्यू कॉलेज ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर इंजीनियरिंग एंड टेक्नोलॉजी नासिक। तो टुडेज वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी ऑन सीट टेस्टिंग। ओके, द सीट टेस्टिंग इज डिटरमाइनिंग द स्टैंडर्ड्स ऑफ सीड लॉट, लाइक फिजिकल प्योरिटी, मॉइस्चर कंटेंट, जर्मिनेशन परसेंटेज एंड अदर डिस्टिंग्विशेबल वराइटीज, एंड देयर बाय एनेबलिंग द फार्मिंग कम्युनिटी टू गेट क्वालिटी सीड्स। The seed testing laboratory is the hub of seed quality control. The seed testing services are required from time to time to gain information regarding planting value of the seed lots. Okay, the seed testing is done in seed testing laboratories. Okay, the seed testing laboratory is the hub of seed quality control. Okay, the seed testing is possible for all those who produce, sell and use seeds. Okay, the objectives and importance of seed testing. The seed testing is required to achieve the following objects: for minimizing the risk of planting low quality seeds, to identify the quality problem and their probable cause. Okay, firstly, identify the problem of quality and their causes. Okay, and second, to determine their quality, that is their suitability for planting. Okay, so to determine the quality of seed for planting suitability. Okay, then to determine the need for drying and processing and specific process that should be used. Okay, also determine the need for drying and processing. Okay, and specific procedures that should be used for drying and processing. Also, to determine if seed meets established quality standards or labeling specifications. Also, determine the seed meets established quality standards and labeling specifications. Then, to establish quality and provide a basis for price and consumer discrimination among lots in the market. The primary aim of seed testing is to obtain accurate and reproducible results regarding the quality status of the seed samples submitted to the seed testing laboratories. Importance: the importance of seed testing was realized more than 100 years ago for assured planting values. The adulteration of visitable seeds by store dust, which was packed in some parts of the world, particularly in Europe. The seed testing has been developed to aid agriculture to avoid some of the hazards of crop production by furnishing the need information about different quality attributes like purity, moisture test, germination, vigor and health. The quality control of seeds depends on the different seed testing protocols, which determine the genuineness of the cultivar. The testing of seed to evaluate the planting value and authenticity of the certified lot. The seed testing is required to assess the seed quality attributes of the seed lots which have to be offered for sale. The these quality attributes are seed moisture content, germination, physical and genetic purity, freedom from seed borne diseases, insect infestations. Also in India, seed testing is done mainly for moisture test, germination test and physical purity of seeds. Okay, the standard seed testing procedure for the evaluation of seeds were developed by ISTA, means International Seed Testing Associations. Okay, it is obligatory one of the part of seed analysis to follow rules set by ISTA. Okay, generally established in 1985. If the seed is moving to international trade, the seed testing procedure which I described below are based mostly on the international rules, because most of our rules are based on ISTA 1996. The economic yield of crop depends on the quality of seeds which can be evaluated by seed testing. Okay, 1996. The testing of seed quality is carried out on seed samples drawn from seed lot to be used for cultivations. Also, the quantity of seed sample taken for testing in laboratory is minute compared to that of seed lot it represents. The roles of seed testing laboratory. The seed testing laboratories are essential organizations in seed certification and seed quality control programs. The main objective is to serve the producer, the consumer and seed industry by providing information on seed quality. These results may cause rejection of poor seed, multiplication or low grade seed in count of low. As per the law, means analysis of seed in the laboratory, seed testing is possible for all those who produce, sell and use seeds. The seed testing is a highly specialized and technical job with a view to maintain uniformity in quality control. The seed analysis laboratory includes the distinct sections. The first section is for purity. Purity analysis of seed lot is considered under two factors: testing the cleanliness of seed lot and testing the genuineness of the cultivar. Then section for moisture testing, and third section for oilability, germination and vigor testing. Okay. The seed testing laboratory. The firstly, seed sample received in the laboratory are required to reduce to obtain working samples for carrying out various tests. A number of methods are available for obtaining working samples. Okay, this is the receiving sample by seed testing laboratory. Okay, they generally use jute bags. Okay, for submitting samples in seed testing laboratory. Then mixing and dividing of seeds. Okay, after receiving. Okay. The next step is mixing and dividing up seeds. The main objective of mixing and dividing up seeds is to obtain the representative homogeneous seed samples for analysis by reducing the submitted sample to the desired size of working sample. The method of mixing and dividing: mechanical dividing, modified Hamming method, hand Hamming methods, okay, random cup method and spoon methods. The mechanical methods: the reduction of sample size is carried out by mechanical dividers suitable for all seeds except for chaffee and fuzzy seeds. The objective of mechanical dividing: to mix the seed sample and make homogeneous as far as possible to reduce the seed sample to the required size without any bias. The submitted sample can be truly mixed by passing it through the divider to get two bars and passing the whole sample second time and third time if necessary to make the seeds mix and blend it so as to get homogeneous seed sample when the same seeds are passed through it into approximately equal bars. Sample is reduced to desired size by passing the seeds through the dividers repeatedly with one half remainder each occasion. Okay. So this is the mechanical dividers. Bodner divider consists of hopper, cone and series of baffles directing the seeds into two spots. The baffles are of equal size and equally spaced, and every alternate one leading to one spot. They are arranged in a circle and are directly inward. A wall at the base of hopper retains the seeds in the hopper. When the wall is open, the seeds fall by gravity over the cone, where it is equally distributed and approximately equal quantity of seeds will be collected in each spot. The disadvantage of this divider is that it is difficult to check for cleanliness. Okay. Then soil divider also. It is sample divider built on the same principle as the Bodner divider. Here the channels are arranged in a straight row. It consists of hopper with attached channels, a framework to hold the hopper to receiving pans and pouring pan. It is suitable for large seeds and chaffee seeds. Then centrifugal or gamete divider, also in seed testing laboratory. The principle involved is the centrifugal force which is used for mixing and dividing the seeds. The seeds fall on a shallow rubber spinner which on rotation by an electric motor throw out the seeds by centrifugal force. The circle or the area where the seeds fall is equally divided into two parts by stationary baffles so that approximately equal quantities of seed will fall in each spot. Okay. The random cup method. So this is the method suitable for seeds requiring working sample up to 10 grams provided that they are not extremely chaffee and do not bounce or roll. Okay. I mean generally 6 to 8 small cups are placed at random on a tray. After preliminary mixing, the seed is poured uniformly over the tray. The seeds that fall onto the cup is taken as the working sample. Okay. Then modify Hamming method. The apertures consist of tray into which fitted a grid of equal size cubical cups open at the top and every alternate one having no bottom. Means after preliminary mixing, the seed is poured evenly over the grid. When grid is lifted, approximately half the sample remains on the tray. The submitted sample is successively halved in this method until a working sample size is obtained. Spoon method. This is suitable for samples of single small seeded species. Tray, spatula and spoon with a straight edge are required. After preliminary mixing, the seed is poured evenly over the tray. The tray should not be shaken. Thereafter, the spoon is one hand, the spatula in other, and using both small portion of seed from not less than 5 random places on the tray should be removed. The sufficient portion of the seed are taken to estimate as a working sample approximately but not less than required size. Okay. Hand Hamming method. So this is also important method, is restricted to the chaffee seeds. The seed is poured evenly on smooth clean surface and thoroughly mixed into mound. The mound is then divided into half and each half is mound again and half into 4 portions. Each of the 4 portions is half again giving 8 portions. The half portions are arranged in rows and alternate portions are combined and retained. The process is repeated until the sample of required weight is obtained. Okay. Then physical purity. The purity analysis. The purity analysis of seed sample in the seed testing laboratory refers to the determination of different components of purity like pure seeds, other crop seeds, wheat seed and it matter. Objective of purity analysis is to determine whether the submitted sample conforms to prescribed physical quality standards with regard to physical components. Methods. Working sample. Firstly, purity analysis done on the working sample of prescribed weight drawn from submitted sample. The analysis may be made on one working sample of the prescribed weight or on two subsamples of at least half of this weight is independently drawn. Then weighing the working sample. The number of decimal places to which the working sample and the components of the working sample should be weighed is given below, generally as per the chart. Okay. The purity separations. The working sample after weighing is separated into components. Okay, I mean generally same. Number of pure seeds, other crop seeds, wheat seeds, matter. Okay. Then method of purity separation. Place the sample on the purity workboard after sieving, blowing, operations, and separate into other crop seeds and in the matter. After separation, identify each kind of weed seeds, other crop seeds, and to genus and species seeds. The names and number of each are required. The type of inert matter present should also be noted. Okay, this is the purity board and seed blower. The calculations of all the four components must be weighed to the required number of decimal places. The percentage of the components are determined as per the equations. Weight of individual component means percentage of the component is equal to weight of individual component to the total weight of all components into 100. If there is gain or loss between weight of original samples and the sum of all components is in excess of 1%, another analysis should be made. Also, this is the purity analysis ground should be carried out on power science. Size of working sample is 1000, mean generally in gram. The determination of Huxley seeds is required in certain crops like sunflower and paddy. 400 seeds taken from pure seed and the number of seeds without Hux are counted and the percentage is calculated as percent of Huxley seeds is equal to number of Huxley seeds by 400 into 100. Okay. Then germination test. This is also important test in seed testing. The germination is defined as emergence and development from seed embryo of those essential structures for the kind of seed in question indicates its ability to produce normal plant under favorable conditions. The principles of this test: germination test shall be conducted with pure seed fractions. A minimum of 400 seeds are required in 4 replicates of 100 seeds each, or 8 replicates of 50 seeds each, or 16 replicates of 25 seeds each, depending on the size of seed and size of containers of substrate. The test is conducted under favorable conditions of moisture, temperature, suitable substratum, and light if necessary. No pretreatment to the seed is given except for those recommended by International Seed Testing Association. Materials required. First is substratum that serves as a moisture reservoir and provides surface or medium for which the seeds can germinate and seedlings grow. The commonly used substrates are sand, germination paper, and soil. The sand. The generally size of sand particles. Sand particles should not be too large or too small. The sand particles should pass through the 0.8 mm sieve and retain by 0.05 mm sieve. The toxicity. The sand should not have any toxic material or any pathogens. If there is presence of any pathogen found, then the sand should be sterilized in an autoclave. This is the germination tray. When we use the sand, germination trays are used to carry out the test. The normal size of tray is 22.5 to 22.5 into 4 cm. The tray may either zinc or stainless steel. Okay. The method of seed placement. Seed in sand. The seeds are planted in uniform layer of moist sand and then covered to a depth of 1 to 2 cm with sand. Okay. So this is the first method. Means when you use a sand substratum, the seed in sand. Okay. The top of sand, also one of the method. The seeds are placed into the surface of the sand. The spacing must give equal spacing on all sides to facilitate normal growth of seedling and to avoid the entangling of seed and spread of diseases. The spacing should be 1 to 5 times the width or diameter of the seed. Also, water add to the sand will depend on the size of seed. For cereals except maize, the sand can be moistened to 50% of its water holding capacity. For larger seeded legumes and maize, sand is moistened to 60% water holding capacity. Okay. The second substratum is paper. The most widely used paper substrata are filter papers, blotters, or towels, means generally craft papers. It should have a capillary movement of water at vertical directions, 30 mm rise per minute. They should be free from toxic substances and free from fungi or bacteria. It should hold sufficient moisture during the period of test. The texture should be such that roots of germinating seedlings will grow on and not into the paper. Generally, methods at the time of using papers for germination test. The first is top of paper. Seeds are placed on one or more layers of moist filter papers or broader papers in petri plates. So these petri plates are covered with lid and placed inside the germination cabinet at favorable climate. So this is suitable for those seeds which require light. Okay, this is the petri plate method. Then second method, between papers. Seeds are germinated between two layers of paper. The seeds are placed between two layers of papers and rolled in towels. The rolled towels are placed in germinator in an upright position in the right side. Okay, this is the rolled towel method. And generally, rolled towels are placed in germinator in an upright position. Okay, the seeds germinated on paper. This is the germination paper. Thank you, students.